Loading up into it right now. Of course, earlier we saw Liquid with that 4-0 from Vortex over Carnage Esports to kick off their season in dominating fashion. So let's see what happens now as we go into Level Up Crest. And we'll see if we're going to have our first series of the regular season that isn't going to be an all kill as we jump on into things. And let's see how this is going to start on out then with this PvP. To the upper right, we're going to have our blue Protoss player from Azimbar. Let's hear it for DMC. And down to the bottom right, our red Protoss player from Redbloods. It's going to be Space Marine. Space Marine DMC. Let's get into this right now. Let's get into this. Let's see what's going to go on. PvP, obviously still a bit of an interesting matchup. The Disruptor Stalker is kind of still the way to go, although we have been seeing a little bit of a little bit of Phoenix play as a kind of counter to the Disruptors and stuff, so it's been pretty interesting. It's been a fairly dynamic. It's been a fairly, you know, to watch, actually. I find it a very fun matchup to watch, especially recently. To play, I know a lot of people have been finding it fairly frustrating, as we see double gas openings on both players right now. So double gas for both players to start things off. Not going to be an early expand here from either. Just going to be fast two gateways from both, actually. So both of them, right from the start of this game, looking to apply pressure. And, you know, you can kind of imagine that this was going to be the case. They wanted to play aggressively and not a macro game, as we had the kind of bigger macro maps vetoed out of this. We were left with kind of Level Up Crest and Ulrana as the last two maps to choose from. So again, not really a surprise at all to see that it's going to be one of these two maps. To see that if it's going to be one of these two maps, then the players genuinely want to play a bit more of an aggressive game. Lepsid, I know you're a mod, and you subbed as well back in July, right? I was just saying welcome to the sub club, welcome to your sub icon thing. I don't have a name for the subs. I don't have a name for the subs, so I apologize. But yeah, I know you're a mod. I see you in here all the time. And stuff. Don't worry, I didn't forget. I know I'm pretty BM. I know I'm pretty rubbish sometimes. Not this time. As early on here, we have just probe scan around. They've obviously at this point realized where their opponents are not. But we do see the first Stalkers on the way for both players. Chrono Boost being spent slightly differently for both players right now, as we see the Chrono Boost on a Stalker here for Space Marine and the Chrono Boost on a Warp Gate for DMC. Now, Space Marine is dropping down the Stargate, so he's going to attack fairly quickly here in this game. And as we see these two Stalkers coming across the map, we'll see DMC actually picking off that scout and probe, but this is a nice scout from Space Marine. So he scouts, he sees the Warp Gate on being Chrono Boosted. That's good information. Now, DMC didn't scout just yet. He'll come in a little bit later here, and Space Marine, is he going to intercept this probe? He will see it, and he will turn around. That's going to be some good scouting denial here as well. He does see two Stalkers, but both players should be failing as they're in fairly similar positions right now, as, you know, two Stalkers out a piece. And we see a third gate now being added on for Space Marine. Still just Warp Gate on the way up for DMC. No third gate, no tech from him at all just yet, as he's going to now drop down his Nexus. So he will begin to expand. He spends his next little bit of money on a couple of sentries. But Space Marine, what he's going to try to do here is very interesting. He's actually going to try and distract at the front, pull these Stalkers away from the main base. As he goes into the main base with the Oracle, hope to get some damage done. Now, he's actually, both players have kind of ended up going around each other here. And we'll see these Stalkers going to try to work their way against this Nexus. We're going to see DMC coming up here. And, well, there'll be less help from this Nexus for him to work down. He's going to get rid of the Pylon. The Pylon will be able to come into play if he wants to build a Mothershell. The Stalkers are going to go into the main. They're going to stop the Mothership Core from getting into the main base. All of a sudden, there's nothing to defend this Oracle. And this is absolutely huge. Big play by Space Marine. He's going to stop the Mothership Core getting in. Can you stop the Overcharge? Oh, one Overcharge goes down, but two sentries are being killed off. At the same time, Stalkers are over here. But the Mothership Core is in position for Space Marine. He will turn this away. And he is getting a lot of damage done. But he runs into the Overcharge. It goes down just in time. And he just has so many Stalkers over here. The Oracle as well, adding so much damage. 14 workers killed, and DMC, he just can't fight against this. GG will be called. Is today just going to be the day of quick game after quick game after quick game coming out of things to say? This is why I like to do breaks instead, but can't do a break after that quick a game, and we just did a break so soon as stuff. So anyways, here we are. So let's introduce our players. The bottom left side of the map representing Redbloods here in this best of seven all kill series. It's going to be our red Protoss player. It is Space Marine. And to the upper right side of the map will be our blue Terran player. Let's see it for Izimba's dragon. So getting set up into this, wait to see what's going to happen again. Dusk Towers, so we can generally expect some passive sort of play early on in the game. Not expecting kind of super kind of, you know, any kind of super rush play. Probably expecting this game to go a little bit longer than most. Because again, I mean, even, you know, past three bases, the fourth base is very easy to expand into. Whether you take it over here, it's a very easy base to defend generally. So generally, I mean, again, only really one kind of main attack path through the center. Kind of splits up a little bit kind of once you're halfway across. But in general, it's a very, you know, it really is a map where you just see these longer games on and so on. As we have good luck, have fun being called by our players. With a smiley face, with an exclamation mark. And these guys, happy to wish fun and luck onto their opponents. As again, early on, we're just seeing what looks to be some expansion-based play from both players. Looks as though the command cell will come down very shortly over towards the natural. And I already see the Nexus on the way down for Space Marine and his natural as well. He's checking for any kind of crazy proxies or anything just outside around his third base. And it looks as though he's not too interested in going across the map. If he doesn't see any proxies, he's just going to come back home and get this probe back to mining. So this probe going to come back up to the high ground, and we see the Cybercore on the way down, second gas being taken. Again, it's a very standard setup here for early on from Space Marine. He just wants to take this slow and steady while getting into a good position early in this game. We see an SCV coming across the map from Dragon to look to see what he can get up to. And just wants to get a bit of information himself. I mean, there's not very much a Terran can do super early on to be too afraid of from Space Marine's point of view. But for Dragon, of course, he wants to know that there's an expansion. There's not going to be an early, you know, super early Oracle or anything like that, as he will just check the natural. He might even be able to check the robo facility here on his way out, but he doesn't bother to. He actually just moves away. He doesn't check the main base once again. So this is some tech which has been hidden away so far by Space Marine. And that fast robo facility are likely to see a warp prism coming out nice and quickly, and some fast adepts over to the Terran side of the map, as we see an SCV here. It's just gonna be chilling out this side of the map. I think for the most part he'll probably just be looking to head back in and check for a third base at some point, or maybe even try and sneak in towards the main and get some more information as well. So there's a couple of different options. We see these Marines gonna aggressively push this adept back straight away, and wall is up so that Dragon can deny that adept access to his main. One Marine goes down as the adept does manage to get away, only losing one hit point apart from shields. Dragon invests into a Reaper and a Marine now as well, which is probably to kind of scout a little bit with the Reaper, I guess, try and get some information. As you see, a couple more gateways building up here. Out of the robot facility so far, we've actually just seen an Observer. So Space Marine actually just playing this a little bit slow, not going to go for that Warp Prism play. Just wants to be safe, just wants to be sure and see what he's up against. I make sure he's not going to die to anything too early on. A couple more gates get dropped down for him here. Now the Twilight Council is, again, just on the way up now. And we'll be finishing up here very shortly. So, just playing safe too, but it's not a super fast third or anything. And just wants to try and get some information with his observers here early on, as we're going to see this CV. Gonna bait these adepts away a little bit. Now the Reaper will come in and kick one shot off of a pylon. And we'll be able to move into the natural as well, but hasn't really gained any further information. Does see the robo facility now, as he comes in with this Reaper, and does actually pick off a probe, which is nice. But not the end of the world, as it will now get taken down. So he saw the robot, so you can be expecting of kind of a warp prism or so. A cyclone is already out for Dragon. He's adding on a couple more Marines. Starport building and a command center on the way here in this main base. As we see a few more SCVs just continuing to come up. And Dragon just going to patrol the cyclone where he thinks the warp prism might come in. However, right now, warp prism's heading in towards the natural. And so all these units positioned in the main, well, they're not going to be too fast to respond to a drop in the natural, as this could be a little bit deadly. Space Marine probably stop here, warp in a few adepts or so, or maybe over here. Warp in a few adepts, lift them up, and then get ready to move forward. He's getting a Dark Shrine as well as his follow-up, so there will be more aggression for him very soon. He sees his opponent has not got any units over in position at the natural, so he knows that's probably the right place to drop, although he does move away with the warp prism now. Did he see the Widowmine? I think he might have just seen the Widowmine on the edge of his vision, burrowing, and so he moved away and got away from that. The Widowmine actually very well positioned to pick off a warp prism or something along those lines. From heading in, well, pretty much just a warp prism is positioned to me. What else is going to kind of come along this direction? that I wouldn't mind going to kill, so wouldn't mind well positioned to kind of deny the War Prism here, as we see the third base on the way up for our Poros player. Of course, obviously, we do see the the first CC coming up for Dragon as well. Bit of a wall here to stop a depth pressure as well from being too effective. Scan kills an Observer, and he's getting into a couple more racks. So, yeah, Viking now out as well, going to go War Prism hunting. We'll run right into this War Prism over here, which will still commit in towards the main. But, I mean, he's going to run into a... it was just a bit of a disaster altogether. He warped in the DTs, but... I mean, there's a turret up, he lost the War Prism. Scan goes down, DT's cleaned up, and Space Marine doesn't really achieve anything at all. Yeah. In game number one. He probes down towards the third base, looking to continue mining here right now, and, you know, just getting this economy set up. Dragon still yet to move his third base onto the map, as his extra barracks do finish. He'll add on some Stimpak, he'll add on combat shields as well. I'm gonna see a Liberator. On the way across the map too, so Dragon gonna start being a little bit aggressive himself, using this Liberator as a way to siege up some mineral eyes, get some damage done, get some probe kills, slow the Poros player down, keep him distracted and keep him busy while he establishes his third base, while he establishes his stim, his combat shields, the rest of his bio upgrades, while he just gets in towards his general mid game here. We see a reactor finishing up at the factory. Wouldn't be surprised to see the starport move over to there in a few moments time. We'll see what composition Dragon wants to go for now in a couple of moments as well. As this factory moves over, we'll see if it's a reactor, we'll see if it's a tech lab, and that will give us a bit of an idea as to what to expect in terms of factory production in this game. Is it going to be tanks? Is it going to be widow mines? What exactly is he going to go for? Let's see another Liberator. Moving out onto the map, as this first Liberator comes in, can't really find a position over towards the third base to do any damage, as a couple of SCVs get killed, not sure by what. It looks like it got cleaned up though, whatever it was. As this Liberator sieges up, kills a Stalker, but that will be it. As the Stalkers take down that Liberator with a fair amount of ease. As one, two probes will go down over here. Three now, and actually they'll keep getting probes as they pop out of that gas. That's actually pretty nice. Five probes in total. And that'll be it. Sorry, just four probes in total. So four probes in total from Dragon. Lost one Liberator, has the other alive, and actually Space Marine with this pylon placement here. This is nine Stalkers into this position to actually shoot against the Liberator, so that's a little bit of a shame. As we see both players continue to tech up, continue heading towards kind of the mid-game now. High Templar's on the way, Storm on the way. Upgrades are finishing up on both sides, heading towards the 1-1, plus two upgrades are starting. Stim and Combat Shields are finishing, again that Storm's about to finish from Space Marine. So opting to play kind of a High Templar-based opening here, kind of High Templar, Immortal. He's got Blink, of course, already. And Resonating Glaives 2 off of the Twilight Council. So, I mean, he's just building up his upgrades, building up his army composition. It's nothing too crazy here at all. And, you'll see Hallucinated Phoenix moving onto the map to get a bit of an idea as to what is going on. And we see Dragon starting to move forwards here with, with his entire army, basically. I mean, Stim is finishing, his 1-1's finishing, so it's an alright sort of time for him to push forwards. But again, his opponent's about to have Stim. So can he really take a fight here? That's going to be a question. As the Storm picks off a couple of Marines at the front. Has to be careful. I mean, it's only one Liberator, but still, it's a lot of DPS that goes down here. As these Adepts will probably transfer their shade, cancel their shades, and not commit to warping in on top of the Terran army. Not the smartest of ideas. As we see a scan coming down here, Dragon keeping an eye on his opponent's composition and what his opponent has and where exactly he is as well. Still pretty much just pure bio, a single Liberator production coming out every now and then from a second starport, a single Widowmine too. As you see this army going to start moving forwards, Tank and Liberator goes down very quickly here. Widowmine goes off and just connects on a few of the Zealots at the front, Storm to help ward this away right now. And Space Marine will just keep this aggressive position towards the front as he actually lifts up an Immortal, whether that was meant to happen or what, I'm not sure. We'll see in a moment or two, no it wasn't, but we'll send this War Prism away over to this side, lifts up a couple of Adepts. And we'll just head in towards the main base with these. Look to get a little bit of damage done. And the next few moments, we must be careful because there's a War Prism here. A missile turret here, which will turn this War Prism away. And they're just going to try and find whatever damage they can, but they get caught pretty quickly. Fast response, as we see the depths just moving forwards a little bit. A couple of SCVs being killed off, so they try and push out. And we see the first these medevacs coming back into position. And just helping to hold this fourth base right now. Again, fourth base set up for Space Marine, who is continuing to tech here. Air weapons on the way, Stargate coming down, another Immortal coming up as well. And just in general, what we're seeing right now is that our Poros players beginning to prepare for the late game, looking to probably go into Tempest. There's the Fleet Beacon and second star Port or Stargate as well. So he's just getting set up for the late game, getting ready to go into Tempest and kind of go from there. As we see, continue just pushing the front, doing a little bit of damage when he can. He's got these Templars to push his opponent back if he needs to. As these Adepts will come forward, give him an idea of where his opponent's army is. See, he's only 3 medevacs, and that might be something which may give him a bit of an idea that there is a drop on the way out on the map. There's an Observer over here as well, which should catch the edge of this drop, and does see it right now. In fact, it flies right on into it. This drop's going to start coming in. There's not a lot here for Space Marine, though. Still keeping a lot of his army out in the middle of the map. Mothership Core comes back in as well. Photo charges will begin to come down, as these Sorgas are picking off the medevacs, going to force these units to commit into this base. And he'll clean this up fairly easily as moving forwards here as well. It looks like the Warpers are just going to get away from the Cyclone. The Cyclone actually now falls as well. We're going to see a bit of a blink forwards to kill off these last few bio units towards the front. The Space Marine starts to edge out a bit of a supply lead in this game. We're going to see a Guardian Shield being popped. Oh, a couple of Zaz at the front still have to be a little bit careful here right now. With these Stalkers, Immortals, Templar as well, just going to continue trading. We're looking to see what they can get up to. A Liberator coming into position here. And I mean, again, Space Marine trying to hold this aggressive positioning and just try and push his opponent away and slow him from getting this fourth base. But it looks like the Dragon has a good enough defensive setup now. There's enough Liberators to hold on for him. Of course, for Space Marine, he's going to start rallying Tempest across the map. And as Tempest get over here, these Liberators will start being pushed back very slowly but very surely. And I mean, as you start losing your Liberators, uh-oh. You know, Liberators start going down, all of a sudden you find yourself in a bit of a tough spot because your Liberators go down. What have you got left to really fight this Protoss army? Bio? Well, that on its own is not going to be too great. As you see this army moving forwards and looking to see what it might be able to get up to here in the next couple of moments. Still a lot of Liberators though, so again, it's really going to be about these Tempests coming in and just slowly picking away at these Liberators. Again, something that would be really nice would be if he was able to get an Oracle out, get a Revelation down, and see what's sort of going on. Big sin forwards by Dragon, however, the army out of Space Marine is nearby to help back this up. A couple of cannons coming in the middle of the map as well. So really just hoping to continue to split this map, stop his opponent from pushing forwards aggressively. And then he has his own time, you know, he works in his own time to pick away at units, to use these Tempests to pick away at the Liberators and to get into the position he wants to be in. As you just see a couple of Adepts walk into their desks as they go into the Liberator range there. Fifth base finishing up for Space Marine back at home as well. And from Dragon's point of view, what do you really do? I suppose you just try and drop, because anything else you do at this point is, you know, you can't really fight this army, I don't think. And, you know, you're set up defensively, so it's really about just dropping and just, you know, taking your time in terms of trading. Is whoa, bit of a miscontrol. These Tempests, they run right into this army. The Tempests are going to go down so quickly. Huge storms all over the place, though, and a lot of this bio. But Space Marine, bit of a miscontrol there, going to lose his Tempests. The last one going down now is another storm falls. Continuing to do as much as he can against this army, and again, he's actually trading sort of okay against this army of dragons still. Them storms really helping him out as he is just going to lose another immortal, however. Couple more Tempests coming forwards, another storm from the back as well. As Dragon takes some much needed room on this map, another Liberator will fall now also. You'll see a Stalker over here will blink away. Space Marine saves this, gets rid of it, pulls it back, and just using it there to kind of scout the lack of a fifth base. So Space Marine kind of messed up his engagement at the start of that, lost his Tempest, sent them way further forward than they ever needed to be. However, he still just about holds in, holds on. We have a couple of Tempests still overhead here. We've got a Liberator. I'm going to be moving over to the right-hand side of the map, and we'll go the long way around to try and get some damage done around the map. But again, I mean, if you look at this overall, I mean, Space Marine's continuing to expand. He's been building up a bit of a bank. And his Tempest count will start to increase again. I mean, at the same time, I mean, all that sounds well and good for Space Marine, and, you know, I thought it was actually pretty good, but when I think about it, when you look at this, you know, Dragon is building up into some ghosts, his Liberator count keeps on rising. I still think he's missing, Space Marine is still just missing an Oracle here to help him out a little bit. Has to be careful, losing a couple of Zealots here into Liberator range, as some probes will begin to go down. Drops to the top side of the map as well, and this Marauder drop will try to snipe bases as fast as possible, but the Zealots should be pretty good against this. I mean, you can kite, and takes a lot of micro, and consistent micro, and you see that Dragon actually just lifts up and moves away some Stalkers as well to help chase this down. And these two medevacs have to pull away right now. So Vikings continue to come out. Vikings are going to be the sort of answer to really help push these Tempests away. A much better anti-air against these massive Tempests than the Liberators are. I mean, the Liberators are okay, but the Vikings just do a little bit more and just take down the Tempests a little bit faster than the Liberators do. So I guess once again, you know, you don't want to have your Liberators. You want to have the Liberators you have sieged up as well. You don't want them just chasing Tempests, because you still want DPS onto the ground army as well right here. As we see this army of Space Marine just moving around a little bit. A couple of scans coming down from the Templar. Keeping an eye on what's going on. Trying to keep an eye on where his opponent's army is. And, yeah, I mean, both players are going to max out once again. However, it's Space Marine with the much larger bank. Now, Space Marine, who's still expanding around the map. I mean, okay, so is Dragon. But Frost player's been expanding just a little bit faster. It's not a lot. But it is something. As we're going to see a bit of an engagement start to come down here. Liberator's taking quite a lot of damage, and Storm's coming down as well. As these guys are going to see a Stim over here, he's going to pick off an Immortal. The Vikings Liberator's a little bit out of position. A couple of VMPs trying to drop down, but not really landing on anything just yet. Nothing significant, at least, as we see Liberator and Drop's going to come back into play from Dragon to the top left side of the map. But there's some use here, and still think he should be fairly okay against this, as this push towards the fifth base of the Terran player continues right now. Just dancing with these Tempests, continue to get free damage done. Let's use it back here. We'll get cleaned up by these Zealots in just a few moments time. There's a Liberator as well, picking off a few probes all at the same time. And this harassment on around the map is going to force Space Marine to just slow down a moment or two, clean it up before he kind of returns to the kind of the dance right now with these Stalkers and so on. Big EMP on the Immortals there, actually. A big EMP on the Immortals. Obviously, that sets off the barrier as well. And obviously, the EMP is already down, so Immortals lose all of their shields. Barrier on cooldown. Space Marine has to pull away from this. That's a bit of a flimsy army he has right now. I mean, the Tempests are very powerful, but wants to regen some shields from them EMPs. Another EMP going to come in, though? No. Actually, the Tempests cleaning that out nice and quickly. Actually, I think the EMP might have gone down. A lot of these Tempests are on fairly low shields, so I think the EMP went down and then the Ghost got killed off. As we see Space Marine still just trying to push into this position. Still has a good bank, by the way. 4k, 3k against just 2k, 2k. I mean, both players have banks. The larger bank of Space Marine is something you can't ignore here. As we look as though we might have a bit of an engagement starting to come down. Liberators will begin to siege up, but he'll just move away out of the range of those. Storm's going to come down as well. Dragon just walks into these, taking a lot of damage right now. There's a few Templars still with Storms in the back. The Grand Army's beginning to win out here for Dragon until them Storms coming down and do so much damage once again. Space Marine just needs a big warping of Zealots and a couple of Archons, something just help out these Tempests in the skies, as we only really have Ghosts, no real Marines or anything here. There's another big couple of Storms come down, two Liberators get caught now, a lot of Marauders as well. The Space Marine still has a big bank, but how many gates does he have? Does he not have enough gates? He's only on 9 gateways, despite how long he's been kind of sitting on this bank. He hasn't really used this time to build up extra production, and you can just see the difference here. I mean, only 9 gateways, there's 8 racks up, but obviously some of them have reactors. Wow, 9 gates. I would have thought he'd be up at kind of 15 or so right now to really just kind of spam out as much as he can when he's in a fight like that, so he can reinforce as fast as possible and just help himself out. Reinforce, trade again when he needs to. And so on. This game approaching the 20 minute mark here. We're well into this late game TVP. Game number 2 of Red Bloods versus is Ember for game number 2. Oh, well, yeah. Game number 2. For the SC2 Improved Team League Season 6. Got there in the end. Figured out what was smart to say. Hashtag sometimes smart. As you see, Mothership Core even going to come across here now. Help out as well. Main base has relocated to the Gold for Dragon. We'll be able to mule that out fairly quickly. And so we're going to see Dragon's army coming over here. And we'll actually be caught, though. Wow, Space Marine actually finds this. And now this army from Dragon is a little bit kind of cornered in. As he is also at the same time just running a few units over here. He's going to take on down a pylon. Will harass a little bit from the high ground, but still, he's going to lose a lot over in this position as these medevacs get cleaned out. He will kill off a Nexus, though, so I mean, he's trading his army to get some damage done economically. So the main thing is that he's able to kind of hold on against a counterattack after this, as them Storms take down the rest of them Marauders. That's Ghost Falls as well. More units coming up into this position up here. 16 workers going down recently for Space Marine. Still fairly equal on army supplies right now. Of course, all the upgrades up at +3, +3 on the infantry at least. I mean, some sky weapons are, well, sky weapons is plus 3 dragon as well, which is pretty nice. Only plus 2 attack in the sky for our Protoss player. He's gone into some Colossus production, which is an interesting one. See how this works out for him in the long run. As, yeah, he's got some Colossi here. He's still got a lot of Tempests. And his army is still pretty powerful. Both players' army is still pretty powerful here. 116-ish supply. It's just Space Marine. On the lack of workers right now, 20 workers down in the game. But that means he's got more supply for army, so if he was to max out, he'd have a much larger army than his opponent. He still has a bit of a bank as well, just still struggling with only 9 warp gates. And there's only so much he can warp in to kind of help buffer this army with gateway units. As we see this, little bit of a pushback. Here as the Ghosts cloak up, but a little bit late to cloak. However, they do get some good EMPs off this army all stacked up right now for Space Marine. Big storms once again, huge storms continuing to push this army back. As the Tempest here comes in and gets a little bit of damage done, another couple of shots going down, weakening this army a little bit more. Wild Mothership Corps appears down to the bottom right side of the map. But these Liberators going to come down, and that's going to be a pretty dead Mothership Corps in a moment or two. Yeah, just cancels the recall. Actually, it was a very fast recall when he saw that it was going down. But it just wasn't fast enough as we continue on in this game. We're going to be approaching the 25-minute marker soon. We have some Zealots DT up here. Big drop coming in from Dragon to this top side of the map as well. Wolfism going to look to try and come down to this location too to try and punish this base at the same time. Some Marauders going to drop on the high ground right into these Zealots though, and these Zealots will get a fair amount of damage done. We'll just pull back a little bit, let the cannons help out with the engagement, which will help out the rest of the army coming in from the right hand side. And again, drop from Dragon, well, I mean, the last drop actually did a lot more than I give it credit for. Killed off a Nexus, killed a lot of probes and distracted while more probes went down as well. This drop, however, has not been so successful, has been a little bit less useful here as Liberators will siege up in the middle of this map. And this Ghost is going to start working down on this pylon here. Pylon falls, and we see Dragon just scan, trying to see what's up. A couple of Liberators run off ahead of the rest of the army, though. They're going to go down here very quickly. As Dragon gets himself into a very weird position up here, he's going to be completely cornered in this high ground. And we're going to see a storm coming down. Rocks will go down. And now this army is truly trapped up in this location. As the Tempest here need to turn around, they need to start finding, needs to be able to start killing these Vikings, these Liberators as well. As the Vikings go down, he'll be able to, with everything else, and more or less be able to deal with the rest of this army, which has begun to elevate down to the low ground. Still going to be kind of cornered to some extent in this sort of location, especially if the Tempest catch the medevacs. It would be very dangerous to start picking up and leaving right now. And he's just going to turn and fight. This is an expensive army for Dragon. A lot of Ghosts here, which land the EMPs, but don't do too much else. They'll go down. The medevacs also. And again, I mean, well, it's just losing the Ghost. It's so expensive. I mean, it's not the Hero Ghost. Hero Ghost! I mean, it's like, it's been okay. You know, it's not been a bad trade from Dragon. It's just Space Marine still has so much bank. And losing the Ghost is the real problem. If he got out of there with all of his Ghosts, it might not have been so bad if he didn't take the fight. I mean, he's just been overcommitted to a couple of positions which he didn't really need to attack into at any point. And, what we see right now is, Protoss player moving over to the right-hand side a little bit. We're gonna see what's gonna happen. Dragon just slowly, setting up this gold base. It's been landed for some time, hasn't really utilized it at all. The Space Marine is going to send an oracle just a little bit further forwards. Seems to be a little bit careful about that. They'll kind of instinctively drop a revelation there, I guess. They'll give him a little bit of map vision in that sort of position too as well, though. So oracle just going to move over to a different direction now. Scan will locate the Protoss army from our Terran player. You see a lot of Vikings right now. Not many medevacs, a few of those on the way in the production tab. Just a couple of Ghosts as well. Not too many. A single Zara picks off a few workers down to the bottom right. 3 SCVs go down, there's another couple of drops up to the top right side. Storm comes down though and will weaken a lot of this, allowing the cannons to really start doing a lot of the rest of the work. And these Zealots that come in here will pick up a few more of these units. It's only going to be a Marauder, a handful of Marines left over. And the Sliver Warpin will be able to defend this in a few moments' time. We're going to see our Protoss player also work his way through this position now as well. And just wants to check to see if that gold base is there. As if all 10 workers have gone down for our Protoss player, for our template in the last few moments. Not sure where exactly Cross player a bit out of position though, as I see our Terran start to push through the middle of the map a little bit, breaking this kind of cannon setup which has been in the game for quite some time. However, is there enough here for our Terran player to really fight? It looks like he's missing quite a lot, as we see workers now going down to this gold base in the upper left. The Space Marine is really starting to build an advantage in this game, picking off medevac after medevac right now. Where are the Vikings gone? Where have they all gone? Here they are, over here. They're over to the left-hand side. Bit of an odd position, and they're not achieving very much as the Oracle will run in. Drop a revelation on a few of those. This command center just go down to the upper side of the map at that gold base. The Space Marine gonna retake the space for himself. Drops the Nexus over here. And continue to push forwards, continue to look to see what he can do. Tempest gonna try and again just pick away from a distance right now. Whatever they can, little by little. He's a Templar. Again, just gonna stick under this army. And just try and move around a little bit. Just wants to see where he can attack into next. Another Oracle goes down, didn't get the revelation off anyway. That's a little bit of a shame. Let's see. Crossplay, continue to move around. A couple of Zealots down to the bottom right, gonna pick off a DT as well, gonna pick up a fair few SCVs and Dragon. Well, really being loaded on that work count right now. As what we're seeing is both players getting into a very similar position again. 40-ish workers apiece, very similar army supplies. This time, Space Marine doesn't really have a big bank or anything to work with over his opponent, which is, again, the advantage he had last time around. As you see, Scan coming in to help clean up the DT on this planetary. And I mean, again, for Space Marine at this point, it's a slow, steady game, and this is what he has to be, this is what he has to kind of go with here. He has to just play it slow, he doesn't want to overcommit anything. This is a nice catch, catching a lot of the bio kind of split up from the rest of the army. Down to the bottom right, big overreaction from Dragon pulls everything down here to clean up one single DT. Space Marine not going to utilize this opportunity just yet, they're not going to push forwards. Just going to play this slow, play this safely. Might come and try and engage down here. But now he's going to get kind of surrounded a little bit as he backs away from this. He's going to get heavily surrounded now. Tempo goes down before any storms go down. Big EMPs as well landing on a lot of this army. A lot of these Templars have not got very much energy left anymore. He will continue to fall backwards and he will find another bunch of huge storms all over the place. Storms are just doing so much damage. If it wasn't for these storms, I mean, Space Marine had dropped 30 supply down in this fight. But the storms just bring him right back into this. These Vikings starting to run low on Vikings as well. As the Vikings go down, there's not going to be anything to kill the Colossi or the Tempests. And that will be where the main problem arises for Dragon, as we see Space Marine still 160 supply to the 115. And again, that was a bad fight for him to start with. He was down 30 supply at the start of that engagement. And then all of a sudden, the really bad engagement from Space Marine initially, but then Dragon just keeps on pushing into storms, loses so much. And now we see a Provost player, maybe even with just the momentum to keep on pushing forwards. Still got a Zealot or DT also moving around to the bottom right, denying bases. Maybe drop towards this gold base, and well, Space Marine is going to give up his chance to attack and will just respond with everything to try and clean us up. It's just a little bit of an overreaction, I think. I mean, coming over here with everything, it's obvious that this gold base is going to fall. He's going to lift straight up and just leave. As that gold base does fall. And yeah, a bit of a waste to come over here with everything in the end. He picks off a... well, he picks off a medevac, a couple of Vikings as well, I guess, so at the end of it, he does get something out of moving his army over here, but still feels like a little bit of an overreaction. See Ghost moving down the bottom right, the whole army moving down the bottom right. I mean, there's only one Zealot here, it's been around for so long, picking up kills. Not actually picking up many kills, it's only got one kill. It's been here just annoying this base, stopping it from landing again. Well, Space Marine again does just lose his gold, but still has these bases kind of unharassed right now. As, apart from this gold base right now, we've seen every map, every base on this map being mined from so far in this game. Seeing a clump of units coming back together for Space Marine. I'm going to see Dragon just continue moving around. Still about 60 army supply down. But Space Marine just playing this safe again. Trying to max out again an Oracle to Revelation before he kind of moves forwards and attacks into it once more. Couple guys asking in the chat about Liquid Carnage. Liquid and Carnage is over. If you want to check out the VODs, they'll be on the Twitch channel, or later today, they'll be on the YouTube channel. And Vortex is indeed playing. He did play for Liquid earlier in the first team league match of the season, so if you want to check out his games, you can check out those VODs, which I just mentioned. As I see these wagons going to be turned away. Zell going to work his way against this bottom right CC. Again, just forcing the lift there once more. Let's see the Vikings picking off the Oracle here. And let's see a couple of ghosts. Actually, only a few of the ghosts cloaking up. The rest of them getting annihilated here. And all of a sudden, Dragon finds himself without any ghosts, without any MPs to work with. And so these storms, I mean, they've been very effective already. Now they're going to continue being very effective as there's really nothing to answer them. Archon and Stalkers and Tempest picking away at the Viking count here as well. And Dragon just keeps on dropping in supply while Space Marine just keeps on building up his bank. And his unit's going to be pushing in once again here. And again, it looks as though Space Marine will be beginning to get towards the end of this game. As he continues to push on forwards, continues to look for a little bit of damage here, a little bit of damage there when possible. Let's see if your Marauder's going to sim down to his bottom right side and try and clean up a few Stalkers if possible. We'll see. For Space Marine though, he's still just trying to find a position to fight into. Like, I mean, I'm surprised he just hasn't committed already. I mean, I know it's very scary. I mean, I know he's kind of a little bit afraid of overcommitting. It's happened already once this game. So he's just being very cautious, but you'd think, you know, you just kill off five ghosts. And, you know, there's been a lot of times where he's just killed off a good chunk of the army. He just took a great trade. And then he still doesn't push his advantage at all. As we see Zealot still over here. Is this the same Zealot? I think it might be. Picking off SCVs now, and again, just being as annoying as possible as Vikings will get revelated. I mean, these Tempests will be able to pick away at them from a distance now. Pushing forwards, looking to see what's going to happen. Can Space Marine pick off his opponent's army? Can he put an end to this game? As he moves on over here, over to this right hand side, he's going to catch a few of these units as they're kind of out in the middle of nowhere again. Nice blink to pick up a ghost nice and quickly. And as we're going to see the Tempest, the Colossi, everything just in general coming in. Nice EMP from one of the ghosts which do remain right here. There's big storms going on a lot of these Vikings. Blink forwards as well. Walking into that storm of his own a little bit there. So a little bit of friendly fire damage being done. As nice EMP takes down a lot of the Templar energy. And okay, now this might be actually maybe a good idea to turn away for our Pros player. I mean, it kind of feels silly, but I mean, from his point of view, he just lost a lot of energy on his Templar. He just lost all his storms. And he obviously can't see the army of his opponent, and he can't see how small it is. Even though he's 90 army supply up. He has some more. He actually has a load of Templar back here. A couple of them on full energy as well. Which means he does actually have a lot of storms. Another Zealot down here just going to be picked away at. And, yeah, I mean, again, I'm just waiting for Space Marine to sort of end the game, really. I mean, from Dragon's point of view, he's not really mining. There's very few ways for him to get back into this. He doesn't even really have an army to kind of, you know, take a big engagement. To take a big engagement to kind of get himself back into this either. Even if Space Marine severely messes up his control, I don't think he can really, I don't think he can really win this fight at all. He loses a couple more units of Space Marine, still just moving forwards a little bit at a time. Still being so cautious, but not overcommitting, just slowly picking away with the Tempest, little by little. Working away whatever he can. As you see, a couple of High Templars in the front as well. One storm gets dropped down, doesn't really land on anything. Templars will be looking for another storm here, perhaps as big EMPs do come down on the front of this army. A Bros player going to keep on fighting there. It looks as though he might just about have enough to keep on engaging into this, and it looks as though he will. The Vikings are falling, and he will be able to keep on pushing forwards now. He'll force Dragon back in towards his natural. There's still a Zealot here or there, every now and then, doing what it can to pick off these bases. And the scan comes down, just has a bit of a look to see what's going on. See these Marauders simming forwards once again. Tempest just picking off a couple of Marauders here and there. We have a Stalker working his way against the command center down here now. So, I mean, just in general, I mean, Dragon doesn't have anything. He's lost all his workers, he's lost all his army. Space Marine is just playing so safe before ending this game, though. So safe, and he must know that this game is his. Just wants to be super sure about it. This Dragon literally has, I mean, barely, I mean, he literally has nothing. 9 Marauders, 5 Marines, 6 Vikings, 7 Medivacs. It's not going to be enough to deal with this army. We have a Thorbital over here as well. As we have Space Marine. Why is he backing off? Space Marine, please. You don't have to try and make this hit 40 minute mark. You can just kill him. It's okay. As you see, Mazel coming in. Again, turns up on right, we'll get blown up by this planet. His planet's got 8 to 9 kills on it now. It's having a pretty good day. As we see, maybe the final fight this time around. Surely Space Marine will just keep on fighting. Surely he'll just push on through, or Dragon will GG, or something will happen for this game to end. Surely, as the feedback comes down, kills off the last few medivacs, Dragon will GG out the game. Get force spawn, so we're going to get a big long macro game here, likely, most likely. As we get into this, to the top right, to the bottom right side of the map, from Imber. Can he put them onto the scoreboard here? It's our pink Protoss player, it's Kuro. And to the upper left, our red Protoss player from Redbloods will be Space Marine. So, early on, we're just going to see both players opening with double gas. So it looks as though they do want to open without a fast expansion and in towards some kind of fast tech, fast stalkers, as we saw in the earlier PvP perhaps. And maybe look to get some map control early on. And maybe try to be aggressive on a map which is quite large, in which they kind of may say, well, if I'm aggressive right now, maybe you're not expecting it because it's a bit of a larger map, because it's the sort of map you might not expect me to attack you on. So, we'll see here very soon what exactly the plan will be from both players. But we see the second gateway is on the way up, so it does look as though some early stalkers will be coming out from both. And in general, the early stalkers, or adepts perhaps, maybe as well, in general is going to give them some good map control. Gives them a lot of versatility, it's safe as well, and we'll see what they can get up to with this, as the second gate will finish soon, and then we just gotta wait for the cyber cores to finish so we can see what exactly our players are gonna try and achieve here. As Space Marine just coming up here, looks as though he might go for a bit of a proxy, putting the probe in such a position where it's kind of between the, you know, obviously between this upper right and the lower right base. Has already seen that his opponent isn't down in this bottom left side. And so if he just proxy over here, then it's gonna, you know, it's gonna be good for one of these two bases. Now we do see Kerr, he actually scouts to the bottom left to begin with. And so by scouting down towards the bottom left of the map, initially, he knows his opponent's in the top side of the map, but of course doesn't quite know where just yet. So he's gonna come up here with this probe, but by the time he gets up, it depends whether he stalkers off a Space Marine. I think he might just catch the probe. It's gonna be very, very close though. He might just grab it, he sees it now, and okay, he's gonna get it. So, he does get the probe here, denies the information of his opponent, and these two stalkers for Kerr begin to move out onto the map. Stargate on the way up here for Space Marine, another gateway as well. He'll continue to be aggressive off of this right now. He's gonna check the upper right base to begin with this stalker right now. And he's gonna be popping in, and looking to see what's going on. Sees his opponent isn't to this top right, and we'll have his next two stalkers run into his opponent's two stalkers here. So you have a little bit of a micro battle, and a little bit of back and forth here between these two. As overall, well, it's a little bit better for Space Marine in the end, because his stalkers only lost their shield. Well, they both, some of them, his stalkers lost less health. Of course, shields regenerate, health will not. As these two stalkers coming back as well, going to find another couple of stalkers in the middle of the map. So both players, the stalkers out in the map. It's actually Kerr who's going to end up getting a little bit kind of surrounded here by his opponent's stalkers. One of his stalkers goes down already. He will work his way away to the left-hand side now, and will be able to get away with this. But in the end, one stalker from the stalker. Problem is, Kerr's still sending stalkers across the map, and the mothership core is, well, it's out. But how many Nova Charges are going to have to drop just to fend off this Oracle? Your Stalker's not going to be able to help chasing it down at all. As this Oracle comes into play, two Photon Overcharges popped. We'll still be able to pick off the workers on the gas though. And again, just be a little bit annoying here and there. And again, just sit in a couple of positions here where these pilots just do not cover. So this Oracle, not getting a lot of damage done just yet. In fact, getting a lot of workers down into the yellow, but not quite killed. And so the first Oracle isn't as successful as you might expect it to be. Kurt is expanding, which is obviously the most standard way to go in this sort of game. Whereas, of course, we do see Voidways on the way out for Space Marine. He's going to continue being aggressive off this proxy starport. Now, he has a Stalker down as he heads into this fight in the middle of the map. In fact, he's kind of units down in general. These Stalkers do kind of avoid each other. I don't know if Space Marine really wants to fight this. He will begin to, though, and that's not going to be a fight he can win at all. He's lost two Stalkers for one. And, he just can't make this fight happen at all. He's just going to have to try and run away. As we do see Blink now starting up for Kerr as well. You can see a few more Stalkers warping in here. Off of four gateways. Voidways here as well going to come in. Going to start pushing these first couple of Stalkers back. Runs into Phone Overcharge. There's a lot of damage done here straight away. Has to keep backing away right now. As we see the Stalker's going to come up this ramp and going to try to take this fight over here. Voidway will come in as well though, and that little bit of extra DPS might just be what he needs to help win this fight. Space Marine going to start pushing Kerr back, and Kerr is in retreat mode. Oracle adding on a little bit of damage here and there. A couple more Stalkers coming from Kerr, but now they're going to start getting picked off, and a little bit of damage going down on these now at the same time. Another couple of Stalkers going down here or there. We've got a Stargate. Crony boosted, but no production coming out of it. The Space Marine doubling the army supply of his opponent will at least be able to kill this natural expansion. But how much more can he do? Can he really push up this ramp? Can he really try and end this game? Well, an overcharge will put a big question mark over that question. At the end of that question. As we see, Space Marine will now walk in four adepts as well. Again, the natural will fall. I mean, there's no real way for Kerr to save this. This is almost definitely just going to be a case of... does he have enough? He's going to power on through. The phone overcharge adding so much, though. Space Marine is going to lose a lot here. And again, he could have split this out a lot safer, you know. I mean, okay, he's not going to have blinks. He'll be a bit behind for that. The kill's opponent's natural. He could have expanded himself. He could have been in an alright position here. Now he's taking some damage as well as his Stalkers start to come down. Voidray has been killed off here just a few moments ago as the Oracle comes back in. Picks off four workers. Space Marine still ahead a couple of workers, but now he's not even going to kill off the natural. And Kerr will start to defend and we'll start to get a bit of a better position in this game. Space Marine going to come back in. I mean, Kerr has Blink. I don't understand why he's moving away, why he isn't trying to defend his natural expansion here. We're going to see this being targeted down. The Volper, the Mothership course just kind of moved away though. A few more Stalkers coming in for Space Marine. He will kill the natural in the end then. Just about. He won't be able to push up, but now might be the time for him to expand back at home. As you see, the single Stalker over here getting some damage done. Picks off a couple of probes as well. And Space Marine looks as though he will back away. Knows he can't fight into this on two bases. Starts his own Twilight Council as well. I mean, he must have seen at some point the Twilight of his opponent, right? Yeah, so he saw that building. So he actually knew that Blink was on the way some time ago for his opponent. Or would be on the way some time ago. As we have these Stalkers moving around a little bit for our pink Protoss players. Space Marine is just falling back and will begin to expand now. And I imagine Kerr very shortly will begin to re-expand, but not before putting on some kind of counter pressure here. I mean, he's got Blink and he will know that that is his advantage in the game. So there's no reason for him not to move across the map with his Stalkers, for him not to look for opportunities to get some free damage done when he can always Blink away to safety if necessary. New Oracle comes in, doesn't achieve any further damage just yet for Space Marine, as the Mothership Core pops that Photon Overcharge down nice and quickly. And these Stalkers, of course, they do know where this gate and Stargate are. They found it a little bit earlier in the game. They'll come in now and power the gateway so it can't warp anything else in. And they'll kill this off as well. So this is nice. We have a few decks moving in towards the main from Space Marine. So Space Marine just trying to do a little bit here or there. Both players with a Nexus. Well, actually, Space Marine never put his Nexus down. So he's going to continue kind of all in here. He's not just going to go into an expansion at all, which I thought he was with that probe on the low ground. Instead, he's going to go into Dark Shrine and look to see what he can do. And you know what? There isn't any detection up right now from Kerr. There's absolutely nothing. Now he starts his Dark Shrine. But what does Kerr have to detect? No Robo facility. And if these DTs get into the main base with no Robo up, well, a Robo's just never going to get up unless he proxies one somewhere out on the map. And this could be Space Marine's way to do this. These Adepts combined with the Oracle did just pick off another 6 workers as well. So Space Marine actually up by 8 workers. And this might just turn into a little bit of a base raid here. Dark Shrine has finished. We're getting ready to go. into this, he's just, there's the one DT. Does Curse see it as it moves across the map? I don't think he did. He drops his own Dark Shrine now as well. Still just not thinking that the DTs of his opponent could be a possibility. That's pretty nice here. I mean, these Stalkers could maybe blink up here, but they don't really... Okay, they have a Phoenix to see what's going on. Phone overcharges will be dropped, though. I mean, Spaceman has to be careful with what he decides to go for. As he only has this one DT. This one DT will get a lot of workers. But imagine the damage he could have done if he walked in more than one. There's this DT. It could just be the MVP, Space Marine. Looking as though he might get a lot of damage done here. This Nexus may fall. As Kerr uses some nice force fields to kind of position his Stalk as well. There's that DT. Gonna start revealing itself now. DT in the natural as well. And again, Kerr just does not have an answer to these Dark Templar just yet. As they come in to help defend. Open here. And Kerr's just gonna type GG. There's no way. Game number 4. They're down 0-3. And it's up to Mishu. The red Terran player to the top right side of Orbital Shipyard to pull this back. Let's see if he can make it happen. Or he's going to see the second orc kill of the even of the season. As to the bottom left, we have on a free kill streak right now from Red Blood to sub blue Protoss player. It is Space Marine. So. Here we are, game 4. Can Space Marine complete the all kill? Is it all kill season to here today? And again, we've already had one earlier between Liquid and Carnage. Very impressive performance, impressive showing from recent returnee to StarCraft Vortex. If you missed that one, guys, of course you can watch it on the Twitch channel in the VODs or later today. So probably, you know, if you're not going to stay up late, then probably tomorrow. You'll be able to see it over on the YouTube channel as well at youtube.com/sc2improve. And you make sure to check us out over there and on the website as well, www.sc2improve.net. There's a Team League page on there at sc2improve.net/sc2itl. That's a great way to kind of figure out what's going on in the Team League. There's a big list of all the upcoming matches, and there'll be a list of all the recent matches as well. Find all the VODs there. It's a great way to keep up to date with everything going on this season in the SC2ITL. So make sure you check that out on the website. Apart from that, again, just in general, make sure you hit the follow button on the Twitch channel. See when we go live again in the future. And of course, if you're really enjoying the content, feel free to support the stream, support the league. You can subscribe with my mate as well. For now, though, Mishu and Space Marine are off to a bit of a macro-focused game to begin things here on Orbital Shipyard. It's been a... pretty standard setup so far. Command center first into free rack, so you need plenty of marines out here early for Mishu as he drops down a couple of gases as well. And as he drops down a couple of gases, he hasn't really scouted yet this game. It doesn't look as though he plans to Eve. Sorry, he did. He scouted for an SCV. I'm silly. So he saw the expansion, so he kind of has a bit of an idea of what's going on. Look at this Space Marine Robo facility already on the way down. Twilight Council following up very quickly. We might just see a bit of a quick resonating glaives. Opening a bit of a quick resonating glaives push out of our Protoss player here right at the start of this game. This Adept shades up the ramp, finds his opponent's marines up here and does go down. Bit of a shame to lose that early on. As here initially, I mean, Mishu should be fine against the first wave of Adepts. It's the second wave of Adepts which is really going to be scary, you know, when that resonating glaives is up. Or wow, he's actually not going to go Resonating Glaives. He's going to go Dark Shrine straight away here. Wow, okay, so. Big change up from Space Marine. Wasn't expecting a Dark Shrine at all, actually. So this is interesting. So he's going to drop down the Dark Shrine. He's going to rely on the Dark Templar here to get damage done. But look at that scan. Scans, clicks on this, sees the DT Shrine. And Mishu just sees exactly what he's up against. Question now from Space Marine is, does he cancel the DT Shrine? Does he let it finish? Does he start up resonating glaives and not warp in DTs initially? You know, what does he do from here? What does he decide to go for at this point? We'll see here very shortly as this warp isn't. He's going to warp in a few depths right now before heading in towards the main base. Look to get a little bit of damage done here in the next few moments early on in this game. So this warp ism going into position, coming up this top side and around. And looking to see if he can get some damage done as he comes in. He's going to drop into behind this mineral line. Looks as though he'll get a few workers here to begin with. There's a couple of workers going down. There's a third and a fourth. And you should be able to just lift up, or you'll let these finish over here. You will let them finish over here. We'll go to 5, 6 workers killed, actually. And we'll find, again, a couple more over towards the natural. And that's 8, that's going to be 9. As the depths actually get cancelled from warping in there. Still no DT just yet. I mean, there's turrets up. There's not really a lot to gain by warping in the DT. Scan saved as well. And the devs just doing a pretty nice job right now. And we're going to see them coming back in towards the main base here. In just a couple moments' time, one will fall. Only a couple units left over here, so they're going to be able to target down a couple more workers before they get killed off. That's 12 workers killed in total. So a good opening set of harassment from Space Marine. He will now take his third Nexus. Will continue to expand in this game. He will continue to build up into his macro game. With this third Nexus coming down right now. Robo Facility is, of course, already down from earlier in the game. And from the Twilight Council, we're just going to see Blink as the first upgrade here from our Protoss player. This Wolf isn't going to come in and going to fly into a turret. We'll just get turned away for now. There'll still be a threat here on the map. Might want to come around, try and get in towards the natural, where Marauder and a few Marines are left over just to help defend. Just going to look to see where you can get some damage done, really. As he just flies around, gets a bit of a scout as well, which is obviously nice. Stim is finished, but the Wolf isn't still going to get away. And that's going to be able to escape and stay alive right now. Third CC not existent just yet for our Terran players. Didn't drop down on third CC right now. Starport about to swap onto this reactor and start some medevac production. And a couple more Marauders on the way out from Meshu, as we see. Well, I mean, in general, I mean, we see a few more Gazing added on. Space Marines just building up into this free base play. And getting them early workers killed, really starting to add up here. 53 probes to 40 SCVs. 3 Nexi against 2 CCs, a bit of a later 3rd CC than Meshu would have wanted. And Space Marine has a good early advantage in this game, I would say. As the Forge starts to come up so he can start working on his own upgrades. What's the pylon placement looking like? Because we do see a Liberate on the way up. And right now the pylons aren't very well positioned to deal with these Liberators. This position a little bit abusive here that you could use. This position here pretty abusive as well. Pylon's not well placed to deal with that just yet. It's actually going to be 2 Liberators before he goes into any medevacs at all. So that's interesting, a little bit different. And as we see Liberators starting to pop out. And we see a 4th and 5th racks on the way as well right now. So Meshu just building up into his own mid game. But again, he's allowed the Protoss player to be very much so, feel very safe so far this game. Protoss player's pretty much been dictating the game throughout. And just being the player, he's been across the map doing damage, he's been taking the 3rd CC faster, just really controlling the pace of the game, really. As we see our Liberator, 2nd Liberator, moving across the map as well. Just going to look to try and get some damage done with this. Now Blink is up, which will help to clean these out when the pylons aren't in position. But again, they're just going to be a bit of a nuisance, and obviously the idea is just to distract the Terran player, sorry, distract the Protoss player. And just give... Meshu the time to build up a little bit more, to secure his third base, to build up his medevac hand until he's ready to start dropping around the map a bit more, until he's ready to start pushing towards the fourth base. Liberators are going to start coming in, probably have been sighted to some extent at least by now. Surely, yeah, the Stalker's blinging up to the high ground, going to try and chase this, but will be blocked away from his position he wants to get into. This Liberator in the natural as well, going to be very annoying. Don't think this pylon reaches it, which is going to be a little bit frustrating. He's just blinking, and will kill off one Liberator for a Stalker. At the same time, you see Adepts going to start picking off some SCVs in the main base here. Some units on the way in to try and deal with this. 4 workers killed, and we're going to see a lift up on 2 of the Adepts, but the Warp Pistol goes down. And so Meshu will defend fairly convincingly now to see the 2nd Liberator also getting cleaned out. So, fairly even trades. Some workers going down for both players, and past the workers going down, we also see the, a couple of workers going down with each player, and just a little bit of a trade, a couple of Stalkers for a couple of Liberators. As we see Meshu now pushing out onto the map. Does Space Marine have what he needs to fight against this army? He has Storm, he has Immortals. Could maybe just do a few more Adepts or something to kind of do a little bit more tanking in this army, I think, is probably the main issue. Meshu sees this, he sees them Temple, he sees them Immortals, and he will pull back for a moment or two before moving back forwards again, thinking about whether he wants to fight into this. More Adepts being warped in. That's what we need. These Adepts kind of see, to just add that little bit of tankiness to the army. He moves forwards here. He sees the army of his opponent and knows where that is now. So nice little scout from him. He looks as though he's confident to fight this. He's going to start moving forwards. And he looks as though he will start to push this back. You're going to see the Adepts going to chase this army a little bit. And just gonna... Well, not commit. We'll commit to the shame. It won't keep chasing. And so see a pylon coming up over here as well. More Templar on the way across the map. Sorry, the only Templar on the way across the map. Some more Stalkers reinforcing right now as well. Stargate on the way down, getting ready to go into the later stage of the game. So we've got three Liberators up. Nearly only two, but three right now. So a couple up just defensively here. War Prism goes down. That's a big pickoff. As now he can't really drop. Oh, this is really nice. He's going to come in here. Oh, that's close. Oh, but he gets the Storm anyway. Big Storm to start things off there. And that's going to take a little bit of that medevac healing. And as we see our Protoss player just kind of putting the Terran back on these three bases right now. No 4th Command Center in play. No 4th Command Center moving into position or anything like that just yet. But I mean, again, Meshu can sit safely with these Liberators on the three bases, but moving off of the three bases will not be easy. Scan comes down, looks to see where the army is. Liberators will push us back a little bit. The Adepts, are they going to commit past here? Oh, they are, but that's a little bit of a mistake, it seems, because the rest of the army is already up here. And the Space Marine just not paying attention for a couple of moments there. Will lose his Adepts for another lot gained. So a bit of a mistake by him as he pulls back now. He starts warping Zealots instead as he continues in this game. So, Clone Wars Zealot's going to warp in here. Plus 2 armor is finishing up as we have 1-1 finish for the Terran player. So upgrades are kind of even, I mean, there's, you know, 1 attack, 1 upgrade for our Terran player, 2 armor upgrades for our Protoss. And of course, relying mostly on this army staying alive for a while and letting the Stormers do a lot of the damage. As this Immortal probably wants to move away. Or Immortal will get pushed out of the Liberator range though. Which is nice as we see a couple more defender zones being set up. Of course, this is going to be Liberator range having finished now. That's something Meshu upgraded here a little while ago. So he's got that upgrade, and that means these Liberators have a lot of extra range, which makes it so difficult to deal with. And as the Protoss player, we're going to see these Storms coming in from the back. They're going to get it. Yeah, Liberator's start fingers off. He's going to keep on fighting into this position. Storms are doing a lot of damage. Has to pull away now. Whoa, big Liberator shots at the end there, taking down 2 High Templar full of energy. There's a lot of SCVs going down over towards the third base thanks to these Adepts, but the main army doesn't have much life left in it for Space Marine. He's taking so much damage on this, he's going to lose the last few units here without really taking down too much else, I don't think. Some more Zealots coming in though, but these Liberators are just doing so much. These Zealots, can they help out? I'm not too sure. Adepts still over here. This fifth orbital is actually dying. Imagine if he'd moved these Adepts over and actually started fighting these SCVs. This probably would have been completely game ending. As it stands, I mean, well, Space Marine's still sort of okay here. Again, the Liberators sieged up and being the real problem here for our Protoss player. Probably see a time up going down here. That'll push this away. Storm getting a little bit of damage done as well. These Adepts on the way back now also. Link 4 as one Liberator goes down. A big Storm as well. Meshu not paying attention. Doesn't pull away from this. And Space Marine cleans up this army. Pushes this back. And that's going to be Meshu tapping out of the game. Space Marine does it. He takes the all kill. He 4-0.